Bhagavat Geetha, as we all know, is a conversation between Krishna and Arjuna. Arjuna has a lot of doubts in his mind. He is lamenting. He's not able to face his own friends and relatives in the war. Krishna is there to support him. At this point, whatever happens in the Kurukshetra war field is informed to Dhritarashtra by Sanjaya. Now, who is Sanjaya? How was he able to inform everything? Now, Sanjaya was a disciple of Vedavyasa. He was blessed by Vedavyasa to have a long distance view. So if something happened in the Kurukshetra war field, Sanjaya could actually sit here and visualize everything. He could see what is happening outside there. So he basically had an internal television, you know, where he could see what is happening in the Kurukshetra warfare. Sanjaya used to be a charioteer for Dhritarashtra, and he was also his political advisor. So Sanjaya informs all what was happening in the war field to Dhritarashtra. At that point of time, he was using a lot of names of Krishna as well. Madhava is the name used by both Sanjaya and Arjuna. Sanjaya uses it as the very first name in Bhagavad Gita. It appears in the first chapter, 14th Sloka. Arjuna also uses it in the very first chapter itself, in the 37th Sloka. So Madhava is the very first name. Why did Sanjaya have to use the name Madhava? There are so many other names. He could have used the names like Damodara, Rishikesha, Padmanabha, etc. Why did he choose to use the name Madhava? We should remember that he was a very intelligent person. He was like a minister of Dhritarashtra. So he chose the right names, and there were a lot of inner meanings to why he used the name. So before we go on to those details, when did Krishna get the name Madhava? All of us know about this episode, the Samudra Matanam, the churning of the Milky Ocean. We had the Devas on one side, the Asuras on one side. The huge Milky Ocean had to now be churned. At that point, the Mandira mountain was kept as the churner because it needed a huge churner to churn it. And the Vasuki serpent was used as the thread to churn the ocean. A lot of things sprung out of the ocean. All these are mentioned in the Vishnu Purana. A lot of things sprung out of the ocean. And the most important thing that happened was Goddess Mahalakshmi, the queen of the ocean, who came out of the ocean. And that is why the Samudra Raja is looked at as the father of Mahalakshmi. Now Mahalakshmi then gets married to Lord Vishnu, and from that time on he is addressed as Madhava, which means Lord of Mahalakshmi, who's our Ma, Mother, Mahalakshmi. You'll be surprised to see this entire episode demonstrated in the Bangkok airport called Swarnabhumi. They have the Devas, Asuras, the Samudra Matanam, the Kurma Avatar, Lord Vishnu on top. Everything is demonstrated beautifully, along with a write-up mentioning the source as Vishnu Purana. So if you go there, please have a look. But for your sake, I'm just showing the picture of that on the screen. It is very important for us to worship Madhava, the Lord who's along with his consort, because that Mahalakshmi's Kataksham will help us cross this Samsara Sagaram in which we are there. The Samsara Sagara is huge. We all are finding it so difficult to come out of our life, to go look forward to spirituality, to cross the ocean of Samsara. So the God who is along with his consort has to help us go on the other side. It is imperative that we worship Goddess Mahalakshmi and the Lord together, because our elders say that Surpanaka in Ramayana wanted Rama. She loved Rama, but she did not want Sita. End up having her ears and her nose cut. Not only she, but a few in her clan also had to die because of this. Now think about Ravana. He wanted only Sita, but not Rama. And now he perished. Not just he, a lot of people in his family also had to perish for his cause. But imagine Lord Hanuman, Anjaneya. He wanted to see Goddess Mahalakshmi and the Lord together, Sita and Rama together. He did all what he could in his capacity to have them together and worship them together. And because of that, even today, we worship Lord Anjaneya. He is now our Lord. He is worshipped because he was reciting Sita Rama together. So it is important for us to pray to Madhava, the God who is along with Ma Mahalakshmi. Now at this point, on a different note, if you notice or observe God's name, he is Madhava, which means Ma is the name of the goddess. He is proudly having her name even before his own name. He is proud of saying that she is mine. So Madhava. And there are so many names like that. Sri Nivasa, Sri Dhara. So a lot of names where our Lord is proud of calling himself as the husband of Goddess Sri, Goddess Mahalakshmi. Today, if we look at all the temples, a lot of marriages of the gods and goddesses happen. If you observe, everything is mentioned as Andal Kalyanam, Rukmini Kalyanam, Radha Kalyanam. Everywhere, the lady comes first. So that is our culture. Now let's dwell on the Krishnanubhavam in the divine nectar, in the divine sagaram of the word Madhava, because Goddess Mahalakshmi came from the Kshira Sagara. Now, why did Sanjaya choose to use the word Madhava? What is the context in which he used? Why was it the very first name? So if we think about all this, it is used in this sloka. You can look at the sloka on the screen. Tata shvetair hayair yukte mahatisyanda nisthitau madhava pandavas chaiva divyau shankau pradadmatuhu. Now the chariot is explained here along with the horses. It seems Arjuna had a huge chariot along with 100 different white colored horses. Now, was the chariot really huge? How come he had 100 horses? Where is all this mentioned? Everything is mentioned in the Udyoga Parva of Mahabharata. Now, this chariot is supposed to have been gifted to Arjuna by a Gandharva Raja who was called as Chitrarata. Now, the chariot is called as Chitra because Vichitra was the way the chariot performed, which means that it had supernatural powers. Now, what was the supernatural powers? The chariot could actually go at the speed of wind. It could go not just on earth, it could fly to the skies, it could fly to the heavens, the Devaloka as well. And the horses in it, there were 100 white horses, and they were given by Agni Deva. Now, these horses, even if they died during the war, another horse was automatically replenished. So the horses, the number of horses, always remained 100. Now, all these were unique. Added to it is our Parthasarathi, who is the most unique person. Because if the chariot itself is so unique, the person who takes charge of the chariot must be such a great person, and none other than Krishna actually took over as a charioteer here. Now Sanjaya says, Tatashvetair hayair yukteir mahatisyandane sitav. Mahatisyandane, huge chariot was there with that. Hundreds of horses were there, white colored horses were there. If we just visualize all this, the huge chariot, 100 horses, Arjuna is there wearing a white color costume, and in their hands they had the huge shankha. Now the shankha was also white in color. And this shankha, think about this. The darkness is usually equated to ignorance, and brightness or white light is equated to knowledge. Here, the shankha is white in color, and it blew such a sound where all the evil things would vanish by the mere sound of the shankhanatha. In this context, Sanjaya uses the word Madhava. Now, Ma, we said, is Mahalakshmi. Davaha is the Lord, her husband in this case. So the Lord of Mahalakshmi. Now, what is Goddess Mahalakshmi known for? She is known to be the goddess of fortune. Now, fortune here means, you know, wealth. There is a war, so she is Rajalakshmi, she is Viryalakshmi, she is Dairyalakshmi. She is the goddess of valor, she is the goddess of kingdom, she is the goddess of wealth, she is the goddess of all well-being. Now, Sanjaya, by addressing Lord Krishna as Madhava, tells that the goddess of fortune is there, the lord of the goddess of fortune is also there. Now, he is fighting along with Pandavas. It is not just his blessings alone. He himself is there along with Pandava, who is Arjuna here. So, Madhavaha Pandavas Chaiva. So, such a lord, who is the lord of the goddess of fortune, is fighting for the cause of Pandava. What else do you want to know? Do you have any doubts of who is going to be victorious in this case? It's obviously going to be the Pandava's side. Don't you have any doubt? All this is communicated just by the word Madhava. Now, Sanjaya addressed Krishna as Madhava, which is understandable, as goddess of fortune, because Dhritarashtra had to have subtle messages sent. Now, why did Arjuna address Krishna as Madhava? Lot of meanings are there. We will look forward to it in the next episode. Till then, recite Krishna's names. Be blessed.
Madhava Achyuta Krishna Hare Rishikesha Keshava Govinda Vasudeva Bhagavan Janardana.